Welcome and greetings. Shalom to all and all that accompany us this day to date. I am Alonzo, reporting on behalf of the Lion of Judah Society of His Imperial Majesty from Southern California on the What is Rastafari Fellowship YouTube channel. Now, first matter, all the names, www.youtube.com/user/all the names. Check out the channel. It's a brethren. We're under the assumption it's a brethren. Forgive me if it's a sister. But check out the channel, and there are many more. And, you know, forgive me. Personally, we asked for forgiveness. We had come across all the names, but it was long ago, and we didn't really, it didn't come to mind when we did that video of, you know, encouraging brothers and sisters to subscribe to them that be, you know, putting in some work for the society. But the reason I mentioned this, like, in public, and is because we give thanks to the brother or sister, because what he did was an example for all of us. He made his voice heard. You know, he watched the video and he's like, "Hey, what about my channel? You know, I got a channel too," and we responded like, "Oh, you know, like, forgive me. It wasn't our intention to make any in Christ less. You know, we were aware, but it wasn't, you know, it didn't come to mind. It had been so long ago since we came across that particular channel." So, but the main point of this is that the brother made himself known. It's like, now we know, because he spoke, and so we heard. But, you know, if we don't speak, how can we be heard? You know, if we don't call Abba cannot respond. And so, you know, let this be a lesson to all and die. It's not a small matter to open the off, to open our mouth and make our truth known, and, you know, include our portion, and, you know, represent our part of the body in Christ. Because every single member is equally of importance. And so, you know, we give thanks once more, because you know, that's something to you know, I don't know if it's the proper word to use, respect, but not respect in the sense, but we honor that. We honor that because it's more power to the individual that makes his voice heard. And so, you know, let that all Rastafari may learn from individuals as such. All the names at YouTube channels. Now, concerning the epistle of Paul the Apostle to the Romans. So, open up your scriptures to New Testament, the epistle of Paul the Apostle to the Romans, chapter 1, and let us begin from verse 13. And it reads, "Now I would not have you ignorant, brethren, that oftentimes I proposed to come to you, but was led hitherto, that I might have some fruit among you also, even as among other Gentiles." You know? Paul is saying, "I would not have you ignorant, brethren." You know, it's like, I propose to come, but, you know, either I've been led here, I've been led there. Like, something's happened. But if we go to, you know, this is the New Testament Recovery Bible. It's free. It's really good. It's got a lot of information. There's actually, like, more explanations down here than there is text on the top, but that's really good, and it breaks it down in such a way that the, I guess, to put it in a proper sense, it speaks an English more modern, more up to date, not. You know, it kind of stays away from the whole old English, what do you call that, Shakespearean dialect, or whatever they call it. But, you know, forgive I, I'm having a hard time finding, okay. So, we just want to read it, how it's presented in the New Testament Recovery Bible, because it is a lot more clear. We would understand it. We would know how to put it, how to receive it in its proper context. Now, and it reads, "And I do not want you to be ignorant." You see how different that is? It's not, well, I mean, honestly, I understand this one, but I over this one. So this one reads, "Now I would not have you ignorant." It's just we're from a different time, and so we read that, and even though we know what it means, it's like we still receive it in a different way. So this one says, "And I do not want you to be," you know, very clear, Paul speaking, "I do not want you to be ignorant, brothers, that often I proposed to come to you, yet was hindered until the present." It's like something's happened until now. "That I might have some fruit among you also, even as among the rest of the Gentiles. I am a debtor both to the Greeks and to the barbarians, both to the wise and to the foolish." This is a call to all the wise them. Now we're going to continue in the King James. And let us continue on verse 15. "So as much as is in me, as in me is, so as much as in me is, I am ready to preach the gospel, the wangeo, the good news, to you that are at Rome also." And what is that good news? We're willing to preach the good news too. The good news of His Imperial Majesty Kedamawi Kaili Shilasi, our God and Father, and His Christ. Oh, well, first, let's check this one out. His Majesty. And this is interesting because this is all going to tie into some of the other videos we're going to upload. But let God be right and true, and man be a liar. And this has to do, whatever the emperor says goes. And so we don't have to be believing any other sources, because man has shown that he has a vain imagination, and everything he says does not necessarily come to pass. As a matter of fact, he deals falsely with his tongue. We know that. And so let us put our hope and our trust in Jah Almighty, creator of all that is good, you know, in and through Jesus Christos. Because he's proven that all he says is true and exact, and therefore we witness to that truth. And quieta Jesus, for whom all was created, by whom all was created, and whom without nothing can be created. And this is a more exact representation of what Jesus Christus in his true humanity would appear as. As an Ethiopian, in truth, root of David. Now, we just have to include that because of the text that is to follow. And plus, because it is true, and let everything else fade away. Now, continuing. "For I am not ashamed," we are not ashamed, Rastafari is not ashamed of the good news of the wangeo, of Christ, of Christos, "for it is the power, the chaylet, the ale of God, of Elohim, or Amlak, Ixia Beher, sustainer and supporter, our source and sustainer, excuse that, to salvation, to everyone that believeth, to everyone that faith, that everyone that amen, to the Jew first, to the Yehudai, to the Yehuda, and also to the Greek." So, you know, it's like this preaching of the good news, it's an opportunity to want for ones and ones to take on salvation. It's like we're not preaching a color of skin. This is, I mean, it, you know, wicked you, you know, repent, you know, and turn to the Almighty, because this is your opportunity for salvation. And you know, Jesus Christ is authority and is willing to, you know, to make it happen with the Father, with the power of I and thy Father, in and through the Comforter, the Holy Spirit, you know, just repent. And it is salvation that we are offering. And it's interesting how Paul mentions, I am a debtor. You know, this is the release of Egypt. This is the release of Israel from Egypt. This is the clearing of all debts, you know? And so that's interesting how we're sure that relates. Now let us continue. Well, let us read that again, because we find much comfort in that and much truth. And we pray that many receive it. For I am not ashamed, for we Rastafari are not ashamed of the gospel of Christos. For it is the power of God, of Jah, Rastafari, to salvation to everyone that believeth, that amen, that faith. To the Jew, to the Yehudite first, to the African American in the diaspora, and also to the Greek. For therein is the righteousness of God revealed. Jesus Christos revealed. From faith to faith, we walk it by faith. As it is written, the just shall live by faith. This is interesting. You know, this is the revelation of Old Testament shadows in New Testament light, shining light upon darkness. This is what it's referring to. And we walk it by faith, you know. And because of faith, we are given to receive that which we have. For the wrath of God is revealed from heaven against all ungodliness and unrighteousness of men who hold the truth in unrighteousness. What is it that they hold? One of the truths that they hold in unrighteousness is a make-pretend, make-believe image of Yeshua HaMashiach, which is in reality what they refer to as, they refer to him as Christ, right? But in reality, it's Kaiser Borgia, Kaiser Cesar Borgia. And that's a false antichrist image of what in truth is Jesus Christos. You know, they hold the righteousness, they hold the truth in unrighteousness. And this is righteousness. This is Yehoshua, Yeshua HaMashiach, the Son of God, you know. And so let we continue. Because that which may be known of God is manifest in them. That is our faith. That is our walk. You know, His Majesty said that the Christian life is the faithful fulfillment. It's that walk. You know, we shall, by walking in faith, we shall make manifest the things not seen. And so, because that which may be known, that which may be given to I and I of God is manifest in us, in Rastafari. You know, if we walk the walk. For God hath showed it to them, and we must receive it. Well, you know, that's individual's free will, right? But, you know, we recommend that ones receive it, you know, and just want it. This on a personal level, just want it, really want it. I didn't know what I wanted when I was about to receive that which had already, since the foundation of the world, had been in its preparation. But until the point where I had a conscious knowledge of wanting it, you know, I didn't know what I wanted. It's kind of weird because I had never even seen His Majesty, and I accepted Him for God. And when I saw Him, and nothing changed. It was just that it's until Jesus Christ that difference. But as far as what we want, it's like, I would openly, you know, speak out to the world, and I'd be like, I don't know what I want, you know, but I don't want this. It's like, really, really, really wanting something else, and so that is my advice to ones, you know, if ones really seek to, haven't received it, but want it, just know that wanting it will make it happen, you know, and you have to say it, you have to really say it, and the fact that we think that the fact that we would say it in public, it's like we were open to any opportunity, there came a time when they a friend's mom said something like, there's gonna be a church gathering for youth, and I'm all like, I'll go, I'll try that. I used to be an antichrist, you know, it supposedly in ignorance, an anti Cesar Borgia, you know, because we Rastafari never bowed down to their false gods. Nonetheless, they didn't fool us, but nonetheless, it's like we were even down. It's like we'll go against everything we believed all our lives. I'll go to that church thing, you know, like. At this point, nothing can be worse. And what ends up happening is that my friends end up having to go because we had arranged that we were going to make it. And it turns out that I got a job like on that Saturday, and it was like job being like no, you know, like that's cool that you're down, you know, that you're up for I and die and stuff like that. But nah, don't go there, you know. Don't get messed up before I fix you. And so, and that's job being job, you know, like, that's the way it works. It's kind of like Abraham and the whole Isaac deal. It's like, not, you know, I was, you know, I just wanted to see how down you were, how up you were for I and I, for I the most I. Nonetheless, let us continue. And so, for the invisible things of him, from the creation of the world, are clearly seen, being understood, being overstood, being comprehended, being received, being taken in, being masticated, being you know, swallowed, and then digested, and keeping the truth, being overstood by things that are made, even his eternal power and Godhead, so that they are without excuse. You see, the invisible things back in the Old Testament brought to light in the New Testament, the revelation of Christ and his kingly character, the visitation of Kedamawi Kaila Shalasi, you know, the King of Kings, elect of God, conquering lion of the tribe of Judah, the lion of Judah prevaileth, Emperor of Ethiopia. It's things not seen made you know, made clearly manifest, and you know, therefore being overstood by the things that are made by you know, by touch me, I'm real, I'm not a cartoon character. So that, you know, making even his eternal power and Godhead, so that they are without excuse. This is interesting, because if we could put all this into not this in particular, right? But we could put a lot of scripture into the sun and stuff like that, how the sun does represent the S-U-N sometimes. But different from any other people that speak on such matters, I and I know that the scripture, the word, has been fulfilled, fully filled, you know? And so it's not that it's a sun worship and stuff like that, but it's that we have witnessed who God is in things that are made. We have seen him, you know, we have heard him, we have spoken to him, and we have, you know, we've defied him sometimes. But nonetheless, it's something that is different amongst I and I Rastafari than from any other people. If, you know, I pray that we remember, but you know, a long time ago we read a scripture. And it's Isaiah. Let us see if we could find that. But it says something that is not surprisingly completely true. And you know, we apologize. Give us just 1 second, but this is really, really, we really want to include this. Okay, it's that scripture where it reads, you know, I've given up Sheba for you, and Yeah, for I am the Lord thy God, the Holy One of Israel, thy Savior. I gave Egypt for thy ransom, Ethiopia and Sheba for thee, since thou wast precious in my sight. Thou hast been honorable. But this is a scripture that we wanted to read. Let all the nations be gathered together, and let the people be assembled. Who among them can declare this and show us former things? Rastafari, and I say, let them bring forth their witnesses, excuse me, that they may be justified, or let them hear and say, it is truth. Ye are my witnesses, saith the Lord, Geta, and my servant whom I have chosen, that ye may know and believe me, and understand that I am he. Before me there was no God formed, neither shall there be after. I am Geta. And beside me there is no Savior. I have declared, and have saved, and I have showed, when there was no strange God among you. Therefore ye are my witnesses.